The year 2020 dawned with a new decade's usual promise of new beginnings. But as Lent began in late February, more and more ominous stories of a novel coronavirus called COVID-19 began to crop up in the news. On March 10th, our own Robert Pace became the first person in Tarrant County to test positive for COVID-19. This would be just the first of thousands of cases. To keep people safe, the bishop suspended in-person worship. The clergy and lay people of our diocese faced a future of deep uncertainty as sanctuary lights burned on in empty buildings. The church did not close, our buildings closed. We are apart, but we are not separated. Clergy began offering the daily office online as they figured out how to handle Sunday worship.
O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us.
Whatever complaints we get, we'll live with it. We'll figure it out as we go.
Some offered parking lot services. Others offered worship services via Zoom or Facebook Live.
Now it says rotate your phone again. You can't turn your phone while recording. Oh, that's what the deal is.
The Lord be with you. Let us pray.
Welcome to worship this morning with the Episcopal Diocese of Fort Worth.
A group of clergy came together with the diocesan staff to produce weekly Sunday services as well as ordination services in partnership with congregations. And we all celebrated when Robert Pace, now recovered, presided at the diocesan Easter service. We also celebrated new ministries with the ordinations of a deacon and four priests. On St. Francis Day, our furry companions got blessed in drive-by blessings or via Zoom. These days, worshiping safely in person takes lots of planning.
Here is how to receive communion during St. Martin's drive-in worship.
You can always join us for worship online, but in order to join us for worship in person, you must wear a mask.
And flexibility.
For those who are not comfortable coming in yet, we still have the parking lot service, where you can listen to the service on your FM station in your car and receive communion afterwards and a blessing.
Masks and social distancing, patience and grace are ways we love one another in COVID tide. Oh, and coffee hour. Congregations began offering Zoom coffee hours, Zoom book clubs, and Zoom staff meetings. And mission and outreach continued as we figured out how to keep everyone safe. For example, Trinity Fort Worth had a car parade with a purpose to gather donations of goods and money for Four Saints Food Pantry. Good Shepherd Granbury has regular drive-by drop-offs for local charities. Four Saints Food Pantry sponsored Food for All distributions from the Tarrant Area Food Bank. To keep everyone safe, they set up drive-thrus with the National Guard directing traffic and scores of masked and gloved volunteers loading food into car trunks to minimize physical contact. When it was no longer safe to go to a laundromat, Laundry Love volunteers from St. Christopher put together laundry supplies, freshly baked cookies, toys for children and pets, and written prayers in laundry baskets and dropped them off to members of the community. So remember, just as our sanctuary lights tell us of God's presence among us, so too do you. Never forget, you are the light of the world.